Enhancements to the Stair by Component tool include new options and in-canvas controls so you can more easily create the stair you need. When creating a stair by component, two new location line options allow you to align the exterior run support with other building elements, such as a wall. You can specify the run width on the options bar before creating the stair. You can also modify the run width when creating each run. Finish the stair, and when you zoom in, you can see that the run support is aligned to the wall. Modify the temporary dimension for the run width if you want to change this dimension after the run is created. You can also make this a permanent dimension if desired. When you create a U-shaped stair with runs of varying widths, the automatic landing depth is the same width as the narrowest run. Drag the outer landing control or modify the temporary dimension to change the depth. Changes to the runs, such as adding or removing steps, or other changes to the landing, such as moving the inner edge, do not change the location of the outer edge of the landing. It is fixed for more reliable behavior when reshaping the stair. Additional controls are available on the automatic landing to allow you to control the leg or the position of the landing that is connected to the run, so you can adjust the landing shape. When creating a precast stair with notched runs, you can now join the run to a landing or floor to complete the notched join. After finishing the stair, in a section view, zoom into the join for the run and landing. Use the join tool and select the run and then the landing. The notched join is now created, and the two components are joined smoothly.